parents,
real quick testimony.
Yesterday I went to the post office
and it was a little
like interesting because as I'm stopping there, standing at the attendant, you know, to fill out some paperwork to send a package for Brazil, I'm doing it and somebody comes next to me because they're like attending other people. And as that happens, I ask in a prayer, like in my thoughts, I go and I say, Lord, anything you want to tell this man? And as I'm writing and filling out this form, suddenly I write this name, Alex. And I look at them like, oh my gosh, this is wrong. So immediately clicks on me that, you know, that's the word of knowledge I was asking the Lord. So I turn around to the guy and I say, are you Alex? And he's like, no. Then I say, who is Alex? And he says, well, Alex is my friend from my childhood. And I'm like, oh, wow, okay. Have you been in touch with him? Do you know if he's all right? And he said, well, I saw yesterday, I saw on Facebook that his wife passed away. And I'm like, oh my gosh, was that recently? He's like, yeah, last week. So, I mean, with that scenario, you know that this is really a divine appointment. You're supposed to cry out, to pray, to present this person, this Alex, to Jesus, right? So I stretched my hand. I said, okay, let's pray for your friend, Alex. He needs prayer right now. God is, you know, I feel like the Lord is saying that. And as soon as I stretched my hand and I offered a prayer, this man flipped. He got so mad. Whoa, he was crazy. And he began to say, no, I don't believe in God. And I mean, you know, he was just shaking and everything happened in front of the attendants of the post office. And then I'm like trying to calm him down and I'm saying, sir, this is obviously God. God loves you and obviously he's wanting you to know. I mean, how could I know, you know, this name and this situation just happened? And it's, you know, a good friend from your childhood. So, but the guy wouldn't listen and he began to speak loud and he got terrified and he left, like screaming, imagine. Oh, wow. So this is the kind of testimony that's like, you know, it's one of those encounters and people don't know how to react. It gives a lot of compassion in my heart because this, you know, many people, they are so confused about God and they have so much the wrong idea of who God is. But anyways, if you can agree in prayer for this man, you know, and that his friend Alex and the family, if you see these, just, you know, a quick prayer, because we know that it is a divine appointment. Anyways, and then when he left, the people from the post office were really nice with me. They were like trying to kind of help me out. They were like, well, I believe he got shocked and I'm pretty sure he's going to think about this more than it looks like. And then I left and I was feeling this presence, this word of knowledge, I guess, of this spirit of witchcraft, like bad witchcraft, you know. I believe he probably had some sort of involvement and the enemy was about to get so mad if we would even like do, you know, physical contact in touch in terms of touching the hand and blessing him and praying and releasing the power and presence and love of the Holy Ghost. Anyways, came home and of course, you know, this has been in my mind, so I presented to the Lord and wow, God is in control. But this is the first time that I release a word of knowledge and flips somebody like that, but you know, in a way that they get scared. So as we do it, we learn. And I just want to highlight this, you know, to anyone watching that it's not in vain. It may come out different than we expect, but we need to remember that we're not responsible for the results. We are responsible for stepping out and sharing his love and allowing the Lord to use us and being available, making ourselves available. But we're not responsible for the results. It's the Holy Ghost who convinces people of sin, of injustice. You know, it's the Holy Ghost that works in their hearts and it's God who gives the increase. Amen? So not always we have like a happy end, but we don't know, right? We will know in heaven. God bless you all. Have an awesome day.